You may want to share your Google Sheets file either as Excel, PDF, or print a copy for yourself or others. Let's learn some tips and tricks on how to do that. To save a Google Sheets file as Excel, go to File, Download, and choose Microsoft Excel. The file is easily converted to Excel. Most formatting and formulas get easily converted. Google Sheets data is highly compatible with Excel and vice versa. To download a PDF version of your file, there are a couple of ways to do that. The first is by going to File, Download, and choose PDF. Once you do that, you will see options where you can choose paper size, page orientation, and all other options that are available when you do print setup that we will go over next. Once you're satisfied, press the Export button in the top right corner to save your file. You can open the file with either Adobe Acrobat or any other PDF reader. To print your file, go to File and all the way down to Print. You can also use the universal shortcut Command plus P on Mac or Control plus P on PC to get to Print Setup. Once you're here, you will see a preview of the way your file will be printed. On the right, there are many options that you can use to customize your print. At the very top, you can specify whether you want to print the current sheet or tab, workbook, which means all the tabs in your current file, or selected range. The current sheet is 2 pages long, but when I choose workbook, my print preview shows me 5 pages because this includes all the tabs in the file. When I choose selected cells, it shows me cell E18 because that's probably where I left my cursor. There is nothing else. You have to make a selection for this option to work. I will cancel this print, go back to my file and make a selection. Now when I choose selected cells, it tells me the range that it would print and I can also see it in the print preview. I will go back to the current sheet for print and go through all the other options. You can choose paper size for your print. By default, you have the standard letter size 8.5 by 11, but you can also choose legal size or even custom size. There are two ways you can print your file, in landscape or portrait orientation. If your data has many columns, you may want to print it as landscape, while sheets with many rows may be presented better in portrait mode. If you can't see the entire preview of your file, click on the minus in the lower part of your preview to zoom out. The options under scale can be a little bit confusing, but they are very important how your data is presented. Here you can control whether any of your rows or columns get cut off or overflow to additional pages. The normal 100% setting means the document will be printed to fit the font, cells, and data all being at 100% of how they are set up in the document. However, you may not be able to fit everything on one page. In my case, our personal budget is split into 6 pages at this setting. The fit to width option will fit your content within the width of your specified paper size and orientation. It will span 1 page in width and the rest will fit pages down. The fit to height option will fit your content within the height of your specified paper size and orientation. It will span 1 page down and the rest will fit pages across. In our case, it all fit on 1 page. The Fit to Page option adjusts both the width and height of your content to fit exactly 1 page, which in our case is identical to Fit to Height. You can also select Custom Number to adjust the scale percentage for your data and text, like 80%. The next option that you can adjust for print are margins. The normal option is selected by default and sets margins in between the other two options. The narrow margins reduces the amount of white space around the content, so you can fit more on one page with the current settings. On the other hand, wide margins add more white space around your content. When you select custom numbers, you will see dashed lines representing margin lines, which you can grab and manually adjust to see how that changes your print layout. Google Sheets also automatically sets page breaks based on the paper size, margins, and scaling options you've selected for printing. When you select the Set Custom Page Breaks option, you will see the automatic breaks as dashed lines that indicate where the content will be divided when printed. You can grab the dashed lines and readjust them to places that make more sense. For example, maybe I will split my data into half here and make sure all the expenses are listed together. I can also reset them again by pressing the reset at the top. Then I can readjust them again. Once I'm happy with the setup, I will choose confirm breaks. Once you set up the brakes manually, you will have an option to go back to automatic brakes by sliding the green custom page brake button to the left. Under formatting, you can uncheck the show grid lines option. It will hide grid lines if you have them, but it won't show them if you hit them under the view menu. You can also have any notes, but not comments, print out on the last page. The page order option lays out content for printing. It defines order in which pages are arranged. The over then down means that after the first page, it will print the page horizontally with columns next, and then it will move down to the next rows. So right, then down. The down then over option means that after the first page, it will print the rows down before it moves to the data in horizontal columns on the right. So down, then right. I have this personal budget title on my worksheet, and since it is getting cut off in my print, I will go back to it and hide it. I will add it as a header later. Whenever you have data laid out on your pages, they are by default set at center horizontally and top vertically, but you can change that in the alignment section. I can move the sheet data center, left, or right horizontally, and I can place it at the top, bottom, and center vertically. One last thing we can set up for our print are the headers and footers. You have some default fields that you can place in your header and footers, such as page numbers, workbook title, sheet name, current date and time. However, sometimes these options don't work 100% of the time. When I click on the page numbers and workbook title several times, it wouldn't work, although I was able to add the default sheet name, current date and time. If you're having trouble with the default fields or want to add more custom information and change the placement, select the Edit Custom Fields option. Here you have six areas where you can add information for headers and footers. Let's click the field in the top left corner. I'm going to add my workbook title here. In the middle, I will type personal budget, since I hid it from my file because it was getting cut off. I also like to add page numbers, and I can do that by selecting from the three page number layouts. Once I'm satisfied with my header and footer setup, I will confirm at the top. Sometimes when your data spills over a few pages, you may end up with missing column and row headings. You can't tell what the data is referring to, like I have it here. We need to specify and add row and column headings to our print. However, these options are grayed out for me and I can't select them here. The reason why is that I have to set them up in my worksheet by freezing the rows and columns I want to repeat on all pages. So I'm going to cancel my print setup and drag the freeze panes to repeat the month's heading up to row 3 and budget categories up to column C. Once I do that, I will go back to my print setup and I can already see what the data on the last page is referring to. What is great is that I was able to cancel my print setup, make changes in my file, and come back here to continue where I left off. I didn't lose anything that I selected up to this point. Before I print, I will actually go back and change the scale to fit to width so it is 2 pages long, not 8. I am now ready to print or download it as a PDF. Let's click next. I can pick my printer at the top and still adjust few settings that are available through the printer that I have, so it may be different for you. When I am ready, I will click print. I can also save my file as PDF. This is the second way of saving our file as PDF. We went through all these settings to make our PDF in a print-ready form. Once saved to my computer, I can open it with an Adobe Acrobat, Mac Preview, or any other PDF reader and print then. Since Google Sheets is a cloud-based software available through a browser, sometimes people try to print the Google Sheets files through the browser menu by going to File and Print in the Chrome menu, for example. When that happens, you may see dates and website address at the top and URL address at the bottom of your pages. The print setup options are fewer, although if you select more settings, you can often uncheck the headers and footer option, which here means removing the web address and title. The way Sheets prints from the browser is almost as a screenshot of what you have in your browser window. Confusingly enough, the Chrome browser, for example, and the Google Sheets both have a shortcut for print, Command plus P on Mac or Control plus P on PC. So you want to double check that you get the Google Sheets print options and not the browser one. Thanks so much for watching.